Are you looking for the right venue for your fundraising event? I've got what you need to know. Watch this video and find out. For years, I attended other people's fundraising events and wondered, why did they choose this location when there were so many better locations from which to choose? So when I started doing my own events, I researched and found that there were definitive rights and wrongs when choosing a venue, and I'd like to share my findings with you today. Hi, I'm Jim Dempsey, and this channel is designed to help leaders of nonprofit organizations increase income and become fully funded. It's my heart that we build a community of leaders, staff, and volunteers committed to seeing their nonprofit grow. If this sounds like something you'd like to be part of, subscribe to this channel and be part of a growing group of nonprofit leaders taking their income goals to the next level. Here are the key elements with regard to what to look for in the right venue, and be sure to stay to the end when I'll discuss the proper steps in contacting the venue and getting what you want from them. Element number one, location. Carefully select a facility to hold your event. Select a facility that will allow your guests the greatest degree of comfort and provide an atmosphere that is conducive to giving. The location should be one to which people in the community will want to go. A very nice hotel in a better part of town is usually recommended. Church facilities should not be used, as they may be off-putting to some different faiths or denominations. Element number two, timing. Since the best times to have dinners are March through May and September through November, the peak hotel times, it's recommended that you make arrangements with the venue as early as possible. Reservations may be made more than a year in advance in some cities. 6 months is an absolute minimum for most quality facilities. Element number three, the venue itself. Helpful tips in selecting the right location for your dinner event, including number one, shop for price and quality. Select your menu before signing a contract. It's nearly impossible to negotiate afterwards. Select one entree, a starch, vegetable, and salad and dessert. Preset those salads and desserts. Shop quality over price. Your guests will thank you for that in their giving. Number two, look for a place that will accommodate your numbers. Don't put a small crowd into a big room. The rule of thumb is to find out square footage and drop the last digit, and that gives you how many can accommodate without staging screens or other AV equipment. For example, a 5,000 square foot ballroom will accommodate around 500 guests, 450 if there's pillars or other obstructions. Number three, there are some places in every town to which people will not go. Ask donors, board members, and volunteers what they think of your options. Number four, parking must be inexpensive. Complementary is best and not more than two blocks away. Avoid valet parking if required. Optional is fine. Number five, stairs can be a barrier, especially for the elderly. Avoid if possible. Escalators are fine, but can be cumbersome. Watch out for columns or pillars. They obstruct your sightline. Number six, house PA systems are always inadequate. They're usually built only for speaking, not for videos or singers. It's best to provide your own. Be wary of drop-down screens or ceiling projectors. Normally, those aren't very good and may even cost you extra. I've turned down free screens and projectors when they are really deficient. Number seven, if you have live entertainment, request a piano in good working condition and tuned. It's best if you can get the tuning for free. A piano gets out of tune every time it's moved. Track music makes things so much easier. Number eight, ask that lighting be controlled on one circuit in the back of the room and which will not obstruct the view of the speaker or audiovisual. It seems like every architect or engineer puts lighting in the front of the room, which always causes a distraction to the speaker. Number nine, obtain a written guarantee that there will be no conflicting event that could distract or drown out the sound of your event. One time in Nashville, Tennessee, we were right next door to the Make-A-Wish Foundation mail auction, and I can't tell you how distracting that event, as much of a good sport as our main speaker was, tried to make light of it. It was noisy, and we had to deal with that, and it definitely impacted our event. Number 10, an on-site inspection is recommended before signing a contract. It's helpful to develop a checklist of important features and determine if the facilities are suitable. Element number four, contract negotiations. There are four essentials when working with contracts. Number one, give yourself plenty of lead time. This process can take a few weeks. Number two, maintain consistent communication with site contacts. Number three, save emails and keep everything in writing. Number four, do not sign anything until the details are sorted out. You lose all negotiating power once you sign. Do this at your top two to three properties. Once you have a fair price, call the hotel or site you want to use and tell them this is the price you have just been quoted and you would like for them to meet that price. Make sure you distinguish between an all-inclusive and an exclusive price. All-inclusive includes tax, determined by the state, and gratuities, which is approximately 28 to 29% right now. Remember, the prices listed in the menu are almost always exclusive of tax and gratuity, so compensate for that when you're asking for a menu price from the venue. It's our desire to never pay for meeting space, so if a room fee is on the contract, sometimes listed in a hidden cost, explain that we don't pay for meeting space and find out how many guests you would need to guarantee to get them to waive that fee. Normally, you should not be paying for the meeting space. Negotiate it away along with setup and teardown fees. Note if you're tax exempt in that state. Before I share with you some last minute tips and extras, if you found this video to be helpful, hit the like button and consider sharing this video with some friends or colleagues. And please subscribe to this channel and join our community of nonprofit leaders trying to take fundraising efforts to the next level. Here are some things to consider when moving forward. Try to get free parking. That makes the donors think, boy, this group is sharp. They're looking out for my best interest. Ask the venue if they'll give you one complimentary room for the night for event staff so they can change things, or quite possibly for your main speaker if they're coming from out of town. Since dinners don't really bring in a lot of revenue for the hotel, they don't normally offer one complimentary room, but it can't hurt to ask. But don't be surprised if they say no. Finding the right venue for a fundraising event can help double, even triple, the amount given the night of the event. The right venue can draw in major donors and may make up the difference to acquire a higher priced venue. Follow the tips mentioned in this video and help ensure a successful fundraising event. As I said earlier, the objective of this channel is to help you greatly increase income for your nonprofit organization. If you found this video helpful, let me know by giving it a thumbs up. And if you wish to watch future videos on this channel, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified immediately of the next release. Also, post a comment below if there were things that you especially liked or if there are topics you'd like to address in future videos. For videos similar to this, check out the video in the playlist listed above. To watch other videos related to nonprofit fundraising, go to our channel, Development Effectiveness Strategies. If you have fundraising questions, then our weekly show, Jim and Java, is for you. Submit your questions on Twitter at DevFStrats and use the hashtag Jim and Java. And as always, I wish you the best as you strive to increase your income and reach the goal of becoming fully funded. Thank you.